Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the newest products that the Body Shop brought out over the past kind of couple of months. And I haven't tried them all. In fact, I haven't tried most of them, but I do a lot of Body Shop videos on my channel and I want to keep doing them, and I just didn't know what to film this month. So I thought maybe I could just show you the new products that they've got out and talk about them. I've got a couple of them, I've tried a couple of them, and I can just explain what they are and what they're about, and hopefully it can be a little bit informative and you can just get to know what they've got. And this is like a visual kind of video representation of what they've got rather than having to go on their website and have a look. This is my first Body Shop video of the year. I am going to be doing many throughout the year. I want to try and do at least one a month, if not two. So grab a cheeky little drink. I've got my Starbucks cup, but it's actually not got Starbucks in it. It's got water in it mixed with lemon. I tend to have one of these in the morning. I actually like drinking water out of this cup. So yeah, let's crack on. Got my little vest on, which is quite funny because it's actually freezing, but I just wanted to mix up what I'm wearing because I just previously filmed a video. The first product is the Vitamin E Gel Cooling Mist. This is a new product. I think they used to have a different product to this, and it used to be like more of a fine mist. So this is a gel mist and the other one was more liquidy. I saw on the reviews of this product that people preferred the old one to this one, and I can completely understand why. I purchased this from someone I know because they had it, I think it was 50% off or something like that, I'm not sure, but I was like, I'm gonna get this because I want to try it. And I also picked up something else which you'll see in a minute. She was a consultant at the Body Shop, but she isn't anymore. She's doing, I think she's a consultant at Scentsy, so I will link her Scentsy page in the description anyway, just to say thank you for doing these for like half price or whatever. I think she was getting rid of like some stock that she had or something, but I got this, and obviously it's part of their Vitamin E range, which is meant to be like softening for the skin. What I initially found with this is that because it is a gel, when you spray it, it literally doesn't, like, it's not a fine mist. You can't spray it over your face and you're, you know, good to go. You have to spray it. What I do is spray it here, here and here, and then blend it in over my skin almost like a toner. It is nice and cooling, and you know, it's almost like a little serum type thing or a toner, like a gel toner. But as a spray, I don't recommend this if you, you know, want it as a spray. I like it as like a kind of jelly serum product, but it's just odd. Like, you can't spray a gel. It just makes no sense to me. This is £12 for 57 milliliters. Kind of a random amount of milliliters in here, but yeah, just thought I'd let you know. And that's my little review of it. So if I was gonna say yes or no, buy it, I'd probably say no. We then have part of their new CBD range. They've got three products in their CBD range. This is the CBD Restoring Facial Oil. So this is new. It was launched a couple of months ago, and this is meant for dehydrated skin. So skin that needs a little bit more help with like oils and things. That isn't my skin. I have oily skin. I don't need, you know, oils or anything like that. But when it comes to skincare, you do not strip your skin back from oils when you've got oily skin. You still need to use products like this. If you strip your skin back from oils when you've got oily skin, your skin will just create more oils because it will be like, okay, we need more oil. So don't do that. I love this. I really like it actually. It's super softening to the skin. I don't know when to apply an oil in my actual skincare routine. I should probably know this or just research it, but I pop this on first. I pop this on before toners or anything like that. And I like it that way, and it's nice, and you know, I'm happy doing my own thing. It's really softening to the skin. It makes my skin look nice and glowy. It blends in really nicely. And yeah, I really like this. The smell of it is nice. It's nothing, you know, horrific, because a lot of kind of hemp or CBD products can be, you know, a little bit on the kind of like, it's almost smelling like plants kind of thing, which it is basically. So I kind of understand that, but it doesn't smell bad. And the cost of this is originally £25. I think I bought this for a tenner. I'm not entirely sure, I can't remember, but I got this for a great price. I'm not sure what it was, but I remember thinking I'm gonna quickly buy that from that girl because that is a decent price. So I'm glad that I did get that when I did. But I think £25 for this is quite a lot of money. But if you're into your skincare and you've got the money to spend, then do so. And it's 30 mil as well, if you was wondering. So that's the only products that I've actually tried that they've got out new, because, you know, I don't want to waste my money. They also have a Drops of Youth Bouncy Jelly Mist. So it's almost like the Vitamin E Mist, but it's obviously part of the Drops of Youth range, which is meant for kind of anti-aging, that kind of thing. If it's anything like the Vitamin E one, then I wouldn't recommend it. So let me know if you've tried that. It's £4 more than the Vitamin E one, and I think it's because, I don't know, maybe the ingredients are meant to be like better, I don't know, but that whole range is more expensive anyway, so that makes sense. But yeah, it's still overall got 5-star reviews from everyone, but we'll have to see. But that is a new release. They also have released recently, I'm not sure like how recent, I'm sorry if it's like not recent enough for you, but they've also released the Hemp Nourishing and Protecting Dry Body Oil. I actually have got into body oils and body lotions a lot more this year than ever before, and it's made a massive difference. I do never get dry skin really on my face, only occasionally, but I do sometimes get dry skin on my legs, and I've been using moisturizing products and they've really helped. So this might be something that I would try in the future, because I do actually have an in the shower body oil, which I know that the Body Shop do as part of their hemp range as well, and I think that would be a nice product to use, because I actually think shower oils are really nice products. But this is obviously a spray-on body oil, so yeah, it's meant to kind of make your skin nice and soft, and just like, will it feel sticky? I don't know. If it's good, then it will sink in really nicely, but if it's not so good, then it might feel sticky on the skin. But it's £14, so it's not too bad in terms of price, I don't think. Also, as part of their CBD range, I probably should have mentioned this when I mentioned the product I've got, they have the Replenishing Moisture Cream, which I think is just a moisturizer. I would, you know, use that more at night if I was gonna get that. I've got my own moisturizer on my eBay and Etsy, which I will link in the description if you're interested. I make and sell my own products and package them and everything like that. So check out my eBay and Etsy if you would like to. So I'm not actually gonna purchase any moisturizers because I've got my own, no point. But this is £20. It's not the kind of money that I would spend on a moisturizer anyway, because I'm more of a cheaper products kind of person, unless it's something really special to me that I actually think, yeah, this is worth the money. But this is more like an intense moisturization, and it's for dehydrated skin, so it's really gonna have a lot of moisture in there. So that is also a new release. And also the last product in that range is the Soothing Oil Balm Cleansing Mask. If I'm looking down, I'm looking at my laptop so I don't get information wrong. I won't get this because, is this like a cleansing balm? I sell on my website a cleansing balm and I love it. I'm super happy with it, and I'm not gonna get any other cleansing balms that anyone sells because that would be silly. But is that what this is? Because it says it's a cleansing balm, an oil balm cleansing mask. And that word mask, like, is it a mask? Like, it says that what you do is you pop it on and then you take off the excess, but it, like, it sounds cool and it sounds like something I'd want to try, but if it's just going to be like a balm that I actually sell myself, then I don't want it, if you know what I mean. So who knows about that one? I'll do a little bit more research into that. Sorry, this video isn't, you know, very informative. It's literally just me telling you what new products there is available. I'm not really giving any reviews on them. I'm not really giving too much information. I'm really sorry. I will do a lot more informative videos throughout the year, but I just wanted to kind of just share with you a little, you know, do of the new products. And that is £17. My cleansing balm on my website is, I'm not entirely sure exactly how much it is, but I'll pop on the screen what my cleansing balm is. So I'm not gonna spend £17 on this when I, you know, have got my own. They also came out with a lemon range. I love lemon, the scent of it and drinking it. I've got it in my cup right here. I love lemons, they're just, so I'm so excited they came out this range, and I might try some things from here throughout the year in the future. But they've got their lemon cleansing antibacterial hand sanitizers, which is very fitting for the current times in the year. It's £6, a very decent price, I think. But I'm presuming it's small. Yeah, it's 100ml, it says. So yeah, £6 for that, but I can imagine it'll smell really nice. They've also got their lemon purifying hair and body wash. Also, you can wash your hair with this. I probably wouldn't do that. I probably wouldn't wash my hair with it, but I would wash my body with it, and that's £12, which I think is quite expensive. Is that just me? I think that's quite expensive. They also have, which is something I think I may try actually in the future, or maybe soon, who knows, but it's the Lemon Purifying Face Wash, and this is £11. That just looks like something I wanna use. The smell of lemons I love. It looks like something that's really gonna clean the skin. So I may get that after my next facial wash runs out if I've got some like money to spend. So it's £11, you know, it's not excessive amounts of money. So yeah, I might give that a try. So stay tuned on this channel, subscribe to see if I use that, because that's just what you wanna know about this year. Then we have the Lemon Caring and Purifying Hair Mist. Not something I'm interested in whatsoever. It's £12. And I just think, you know, I'm just not interested in it. When it comes to my hair, I use a hair mask, I wash my hair, that's it. Like, I don't do anything else to it, I don't add products to it. I'm not interested. Maybe I'll change my mind, but it's just not something I'm bothered about. Then we've got, in this range as well, the Lemon Purifying Hand Wash. It's £8.50. I won't be spending £8.50 on a hand wash when I've got like £1 ones from Lidl. And although this is like nice quality, a little goes a long way. I think £8.50 is actually kind of expensive, I'm not gonna lie. I'm sure it smells great. Then we have the Lemon Protecting Hand and Body Lotion. This is £10, and dependent on how big the bottle is, that might be something I may get in the future, because I love the smell of lemon. I've got their lemon body yogurt, which I think is discontinued now. I think it was just limited edition, and I love that so much, and I still use that daily. And I think if that runs out, then maybe I will go and use this. Then second to last, we have got the Ginger Scalp Serum. Now I think this is meant to be for like a scalp with dandruff and things like that, and meant to help with that. I would never put anything like that in my hair because I just think grease ball. But yeah, I'm just not interested. Also ginger, I kind of like the taste of it in biscuits, but in a product, I don't know. It's £15, so it's actually not too bad. Like, I was expecting it to be more money, but if you've used the product, let me know. Let me know, is it good, etc. And it's got 4.5 star reviews, so maybe it is good, who knows. But it's actually out of stock, so if it's out of stock, that's kind of a sign that people might like it. And then finally, they've got their hair and body mists, and I'll quickly go through each of the scents. They've got coconut and yuzu, pink, pepper and lychee, lime and matcha, and then finally, oh no, two more, pomegranate and red berries, and then apricot and agave. And I think the ones that I would get if I was gonna is the pomegranate and red berries one, and also the lime and matcha one looks quite nice as well. The one I definitely wouldn't get is probably the coconut one. Actually no, I do kind of like the smell of coconut, but they're £10. I think I would only get one of those if they're discounted, but yeah, I actually do think I will buy one of those in the future, so maybe you'll see me with one of those. And I think they look really cute. All the bottles and the designs look really nice, so that is also another launch. So yeah, that's all of the kind of recent new launches from The Body Shop. There may be some more that I've missed, but this is just what they've got on their website showing as new, so blame them, not me. But that's everything. Sorry this video is rushed. I'm trying to kind of rush the ending because my camera's gonna die anytime soon. But yeah, thanks for watching. See you in my next video, or my next Body Shop video. I'm gonna be posting another video next Wednesday at 9 a.m. So see you then. But yeah, thanks for watching, and please subscribe, and I will see you soon. Hopefully this video was somewhat helpful in some way. But yeah, goodbye.